Like to say good evening to everybody, and we've just had a wonderful service here tonight, and I'm with my grandson Bryce Asher, and we just like to praise the Lord tonight for WLJC. We've been coming down here now for many years, and we just like to say we'd like for everybody to keep supporting the ministry here and lift up Sister Margaret and all the staff here in prayer each night, and we just like for if there any way that you can to send in donations or contributions to help the ministry here, I'm sure it would be blessed, and you would be blessed by doing that. And with just a lot of church groups and a lot of ministers, a lot of singing groups come gather here each and every night, and they pray. We have phone operators upstairs each and every night, and we're it's just a wonderful event, and a wonderful place to come and sing and feel the Spirit of the Lord that's with us here in this chapel. So we just encourage you to keep up the good work of prayer and support the ministry here. And we love you, and God bless you.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the Hour of Harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We want you to stay tuned and just get comfortable in your chair or your bed or wherever you've joined us from. Why, just make yourself comfortable, because we have some good singing coming up. Dottie has phone operators, and we're going to have church. So we hope that you'll join us and help us to pray for those that are in great need tonight. You know, there's people that are healthy, well, and they're enjoying life to its fullest here on earth. And then at the same time this is happening, then there's others that are really suffering, some physically and emotionally and spiritually even, and just having a real hard time. And so we need to pray for those that need it tonight. Maybe some of them are too tired, too discouraged to even pray, but we must do it for them. But anyway, we want the service to be a blessing to you, and I'm sure the songs will be. So we want to continue to reading about the birth of Jesus. And we go to Matthew, the second chapter. Now Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. Behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And when they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophets, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the prince of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor which shall rule my people Israel." When Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their gifts, they presented unto him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. That's the first 12 verses of Matthew, the second chapter. You can continue to read about the life of Jesus, starting there with the 13th verse, and telling us about the beginning of our Lord and Savior. All right, just before we pray, we want to remember those that are having struggles and those that are sick. Here we have Doyle Fry from Berea is very ill, and Tammy from Mount Sterling had a bad fall, and also for lost family. So let's pray. Let's pray for the singers tonight and those that just need some help from the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the blessings of this day. Lord, you've been merciful to us. You've given us all a chance to be here tonight. And those that have tuned in, they're still able to hear and to listen and be a part of the service by means of the airways. And so, Lord, we thank you for your blessings, and we thank you for this season. We thank you that Jesus came, and we thank you for how that you took care of him as a baby, and that you helped him to be here and to accomplish his mission. So, Lord, tonight I ask you to help those that are troubled about things, that you will help them to be able to release them to you. And those that have never been like the wise men still seeking you, help them to start that tonight. Help them to find the peace that only you can plant within their soul. Bless those that are on the road traveling, and protect them from accidents and harm. And bless our singers now, Lord, and anoint them. And I know that as they sing the songs that are familiar with to the people, that they will be blessed. So we just ask for your blessings on the service. Give us souls, and for those that need encouragement, Lord, let it be tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, tonight we're happy to have some folk with us from Winchester, Roy Jackson and friends, and they do have CDs for sale. So jot down this number, 606-224-0911, and they're all ready to sing for us right now. Roy Jackson and friends.
Souls, oh yes, to linger out of sin with a restless, weary heart and much discord. I must seek the one who stumbled and empty give in. I'm out to work and live again for my Lord. I'm out to work. I'm not working in the vineyard for my Lord. I must tell him all the home I'm sailing home. I must tell him all the city and everything here. I'm out working in the vineyard for my Lord. I'm out working. I'm out working in the vineyard for my Lord. I'm out. I'm out working in the vineyard for my Lord. Amen. It's good to be here tonight. Good to be back up here singing. We hope that we'll be able to sing a few songs tonight that might lift you up and bless you tonight, whatever, wherever you're at. If you're in a convalescent home somewhere, we hope that you're listening. You'll be lifted up by these songs, and we just stay tuned, and I'm sure that we'll sing something here after a while that will bless your heart. We're in a good season this time of year. It's Christmas season, and seem like everybody kind of takes on a different mood and attitude, and we're just happy and thankful for the season. I'm so glad that the Lord came over 2,000 years ago and gave his life on Calvary for me, that just some old wretched sinner like me that God would have mercy upon and he would save. And I'm just so thankful for that, and so glad to be a child of God. And I tell you, friend, it's one of the greatest privileges that you'll ever have in life, is to be a child of God and to know him as your personal Savior. If you don't know him tonight, I beg you to call tonight. Try him. Amen.
When I think how he came so far from glory, came to dwell among the lonely, such as I, to suffer shame and disgrace on Mount Calvary.
Some Christmas songs here tonight, and Billy's going to play the trumpet on some of these. And I thought a while ago, as we was practicing a little bit, they used the trumpets
when he was coming out of the land of Israel, or that land of Egypt, into Israel to call the tribes together for special occasions, for war, or whatever it may be. And so we're going to use the horn here a little bit tonight, too. I need to stay in B flat, I believe. And that was, you might just want to go out to your mother. Next one. Okay. Mother, Ruth White. I believe I got that right, didn't I? Okay. Thank you. Well, as we said a while ago, I thank the Lord for this Christmas season. I thought a while ago as Margaret read over the Christmas story or some of it, at least I wondered when the Magi came to Jerusalem before the king. He was seeking the place where Christ was born, and the religious folks of that day, the scribes and Pharisees, right away they mentioned, well, it's in Bethlehem, the city of David. And I've always wondered why an event like this taking place in their country in that time, why didn't they just hitch their wagon to them and go with them? Such a great event as this, as the Son of God was to be born there according to prophecy. And they understood that, but yet they did not make any effort to go whatsoever. So, but anyway, I'm thankful for the Lord. Glad to be saved today. You pray for us. We certainly do need your prayers. It's a long and dusty road that my feet are traveling on, and sometimes, oh, the clouds seem dark and low. Oh, but I've got to keep the faith and walk the straight and narrow way to reach that home that I will call my home. For my home is just around the bend. I thank God about it now and then. Reunion by the millions everywhere. But the one that I long to see is the one who played and I believe. My home, a place I long to be. So many, oh, this world so dear, I am just a stranger here, just passing through on a temporary stay. But I'm looking forward to the time when all of heaven will be mine. I'll look and pray it could be any day. For my home is just around the bend. Send this program out to the folks up in Wildwood Chapel Church tonight, and also some folks from Mount Grace Free Will Baptist Church may be looking in tonight. We want to send this program out to you as well, and I probably got a daughter down in Florida that's watching this tonight. We love you, and we want you to hope you'll enjoy it tonight.
Oh, to be there when the Savior spoke the great command, and to witness in the wonder of His wonder-working hand. No miracle has crossed my eyes to call. Miracle in me.
Amen. There's sure a miracle in me. And the Lord saved me and gave me this wonderful hope. I also like to send this out to Brother Gaines Rogers. He may be watching tonight. Lord bless you, brother. And we send it out to you tonight. We got another Christmas song here, and we got kind of slotted a few Christmas songs in, and we're glad to, you know, for the season. We normally drag these out about once a year and try to sing them, so.
All right.
Also want to send this out to Friendship Baptist Church over in Clay City. And got several friends and loved ones out there. And I got that right.
A great event shall soon take place, been invited by His grace, and the angels are preparing for me to come. They can't march around the throne, they can't sing victory song, they can't start.
We'll sing a song everybody knows. I heard them sing this up here last night, but we're going to do our version of it tonight. So, another old Christmas song. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine. Song, okay. You can do it. We gotta switch horses here a minute.
want to thank the Lord for being here tonight, and I want to send it out to all the boys I work with and for down there in Richmond. And I want to send it out to, I had an uncle that passed away this morning. I want to send everything out to the family there. Once my soul was astray from the heavenly way, and was wretched and bound as could be, but my Savior in love gave me peace.
Savior reached down for me.
When he reached way down for me, I was lost and undone without God or his Son. When he reached down his hand for me,
I was near.
Okay, all right. We're going to give them a little break, and they'll be back to sing some more for us in just a little bit. But you've been listening to Roy Jackson and Friends from Winchester, Kentucky, and they do have CDs for sale. The number to call is 606-224-0911, and they'll get in touch with you on that. All right, we have Madeline from Madison County said she's really enjoying the music tonight, so that's a compliment. And we have a lot of prayer requests that's in. We'll share some of these right now while they're taking a break and getting something to drink. Here's from Frankfurt. Doris has called, and she's sending a contribution in to WLJC, and she needs prayer for her eyes and says she's glad to see me back. Well, I'm glad to be back. Seemed like the time went very slow when I was not able to be here. Nora for a balance problem, and she's also had some tests done and needs some help there. And Phyllis's family, there's several in that family, they all need a help, all need something from the Lord. From for a sister-in-law that has called in for prayer, Barbara for Lonnie from Madison is having surgery on Wednesday, and Barbara from Madison County for her family. Here's Bridget from Madison County needs a car. And from Wayne County, someone needs healing for physical needs. And Nicholas County, daughter needs prayer, and someone has back trouble. Stella from McGolfin for herself and she, and her husband and unsaved children. All right, there's a call from Montgomery County. Here's one from Tennessee for Tammy, one from Richmond for someone. The entire family looks like from Fayette County for a sister that has an eating disorder. And also someone needs a job. From Montgomery County, Judy, for Justin and Renee's baby is only 2 days old and its oxygen level is too low and it's in the incubator and needs prayer. From Rockcastle, needs prayer for some Christian people. Well, I tell you, Christian people needs a lot of prayer because the enemy sure does fight them because he doesn't have them. From New York, this call is called in and is in the hospital and needs, that's Earl, needs help. Melissa and Roy for several members of the family and also has a praise report. Said Johnny was released to come home today from the hospital and that last week they was not giving much hope, but God has undertaken and let him go home. All right, Jamie from Somerset for a mother-in-law. And also, there's several physical needs there. Pulaski County for Lena, for her family. From Mount Sterling, Goldie and Earl. From Scott County for Curtis and has a stomach virus. Pulaski County, Della. For lost a son to cancer and then lost his wife 2 weeks after that. From Madison County, Mary needs help. A grandfather has broken both hips and a grandmother that's had a stroke. Ms. Loudon, she needs a good night's sleep, she says. And you know, if we get a good night's sleep, the world looks a lot better to you the next day, so that's important. All right, from Madison County for Corey and Tiffany. All right, they've just gotten married and they are wanting the Lord to be there to help them to make it a good one. And also for Roger Sr. that is recovering from quadruple bypass. All right, well, we have the singers are going to come back up and give us more good songs. These folk know a lot of songs. They've been singing a number of years for the Lord, and it's all good because, you know, singing praises to the Lord, and he's told us to do that, and so that's what these folk are doing. Roy Jackson and friends from Winchester, Kentucky. And they've been in the ministry a long time. 606-224-0911 to order their CDs and find out where they're going to be singing next. All right, let's go back for some more good music.
All right, we're going to sing another Christmas song here, I think. If I can get my guitar geared up here.
There are people who are whispering, and the rumors are running wild. There's a woman, she's not married, and she's going to have a child.
I sure hope people. I wonder sometimes. I don't know what it is that why people don't accept the Lord. It's the best life you'll ever live, and I'm amazed sometimes why people keep neglecting the Lord, because you know the Lord's going to come back, and we're going to face judgment. We're going to be judged by every deed that is done in this body, and I want to be sure to have everything fixed up, and I hope you will. I hope you folks out there, that some of you may be lost tonight, I hope you'll get things fixed up before it's everlasting too late. So,
this song is for George Hayes. He never gets tired of this song. He requests it every time he's around us.
The Lord said, stand up and bow to you. We must preach the gospel for many long years. Go down to Damascus, the street that's called Free. My servant on Adam, I counted on Cain, I counted on Jonah, but he was the same. I counted on Judah, but he proved untrue. So go tell the
just go right on preaching.
Judah, but he proved untrue. Just go around the world, Paul, I'm counting on you. So go tell the world, Paul, I'm counting on you.
Amen. I got so much in my pocket, I lose my clamp. I'll do this one, the King and I. I love these. I love these songs. I heard it. Somebody sang it on the radio one night, and I said, or church one night. We said it's church, and I said, I got to have that song. I love this song. So you pray for it.
The King and I walk down life's road together, where many people go passing by. The greatest one and I, a lonely beggar, walk hand in hand. The King and should care for me will always be a mystery. He holds the world in his hand, but what am I? And so my heart somehow can't help but wonder why we're
guys come with us tonight. Billy Wall playing the keyboard. We appreciate him. We used to go to church with him a lot. Our paths have kind of separated. He goes a different place now in Brother Martin Over Bay. We're glad to have him tonight. I got his name right for the first time in a while.
He gives me
So we appreciate him. Been good friends for a long time, good Christian people, and we thank the Lord for them. They was brave enough to come over here tonight and help us out.
We're singing.
send this one out to George Hayes, too. He may like this song.
A midnight has passed, it's morning at last, no longer.
But it still be a good song. This one's a good song that I love so much, and I'm glad that it says he loved me more and more, and I'm glad that the Lord did. He loved me more and more, and I don't really understand why, but he does, you know, because of God's grace, and he's greatest thing that ever happened to me.
Yes, he loved me more and more. That is one thing I am sure. For he came within my soul now to live. He took away my every sin, and I know he's within. For he loved me, yes, he loved me more. Shed his blood to take away my every sin.
more and more.
Well, I'm just an old plowboy working hard in the field. My crop is salvation and the soul that it is. I'll work for the Master, King of the sky. And someday I'm gonna see him when the crops are laid by. When the crops are laid by and my work here is done, I want to see Jesus, hear his voice say, well done. In this old plowboy's gonna head for the sky. So you see me in glory when the crops are laid. Those old precious bedside prayer. We can tune in the throne room by our bedside every night when we lay down our head to sleep. I'm thankful. I believe that my mother and father prayed many of those bedside prayers for me when I was a young man and not doing what I should be doing, and I was living in the world and for the world. And I'm glad for the bedside prayer. Looking back on my childhood, all the memories are so good. There were days filled with dangers and snares, but the devil who made them now that I could evade them all because of this I pray. I remember the voices, the advice and the choices, right ones in each foolish day. But the rights that I once wore, traded one night for a white robe in a bedside prayer. They have power to change things, how they rearrange things, lift so many burdens and care. How could I ever doubt them? I'd be without them, those old precious bedside prayers. Now in these final days here, I feel so out of place here, in the sin-thirsty world that we share. But each night in my bedroom, tune in the throne room with my Father. They have power to change things, how they rearrange things, lift so many burdens and care. How could I ever doubt them? Where would I be without them? Those old precious bits of prayer.
Sing the last one. It's been a pleasure to be here tonight. This will be our last song. So,
if I get there before you do, I'll be looking for you, for I'll just wait till the Lord calls me home. We've had victory, we've been blessed for many years, then we'll spend eternity with the Lord. Then we'll walk hand in hand throughout the promised land, down the streets made of purest of gold. I'm so glad we made the choice. Jesus Christ is still the Lord, and with love I'll be looking for you. Heaven's surely worth the wait, just to see
Thank you so much for all those good songs. Now, if Brother Roy and his wife would like to come up and help us pray for the request, that would be appreciated. Now, if you remember, if you want to order their CDs, call them at 606-224-0911. And we appreciate them coming on a night like tonight. We have a praise report. A month ago, a man called in here for prayer for his cancer. And as of today, a month later, he is cancer-free. And so there, that is something to praise God for, being cancer-free. All right, here's what we'd like to hear about. I tell you, since these folk have done all the singing and all the working tonight, maybe I better let them share this. There's three of them. Now, I don't know how two of you is going to share three, but you could figure it out there, we'll and you could manage.
We'll manage to do that.
All right.
Read them all.
All right. All right. Saved.
Salvation report.
Raymond. All right. We appreciate that.
Yes.
And Rebecca and Donald. All right. Saved tonight. We're thankful for that. I'll save you one. I just had to read them too.
Stephanie from Fayette County, we praise the Lord for you. We just Amen. So thankful that you are watching and taking this serious and answering the call when the Lord calls for you. You'll never regret it. It's a glorious way.
Amen.
Yes, that is so true.
And,
Amen.
Well, and you know, it takes the Lord really in people's hearts to make the difference, doesn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
Yes.
And when you have yes. that love in your heart, well, you're just a different person. You treat people differently and mm-hmm. so forth. Carolyn from Wayne County wanted to wish everyone a Merry Christmas at WLJC. Loves everyone here and thanks for praying for her. Mm-hmm. We have a number of prayer requests here, some of them cancer and so forth, and there's one that had a leg amputated, and so there's serious requests here, and
yes.
they have confidence in the Lord, and they know that we need to pray, so we're going to hand these over to this mm-hmm. pastor and his wife and let them anoint them, and mm-hmm. they're going to lead us in prayer, and we're going to join our faith with theirs and with you, and you know, great volumes of prayer are very strong and mm-hmm. get a lot of things done. And so we don't want you to ever doubt that your prayers are not being heard or not being prayed for you. So.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this privilege we have to call upon your name. We realize, Heavenly Father, that it's the greatest name, Heavenly Father, we could ever call upon, Lord. Your Son Jesus, Lord, and we thank you, Heavenly Father, for everything that you do. Now, God, there's many needs, Lord, that we hold in our hand, Lord, and we're not able to mention them all. We're not able, Heavenly Father, to know every need and ever care, Heavenly Father, but we know, Lord, that you know all things. You're omnipresent, Heavenly Father, in every life, Lord, and we pray tonight, Lord, that you would remember those, God, that are sick and those that are afflicted in body tonight. Most of all, God, we ask you, Lord, to remember that one, God, that their soul is sick tonight, Lord. They haven't accepted you, Lord, as their personal Savior. We pray, Lord, if they're under the sound of our voice tonight, Lord, that God, that they might realize their need, Heavenly Father, and turn their life to you. Father, we pray that you'd bless Sister Margaret, Lord, in the work that's done here at the station every night. Father, we praise you, Lord, for everything that you do. And we pray that you'd continue, Lord, to strengthen her, Lord, that she might be able to do this work and carry it on. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we praise you tonight for everything, Lord, that you do for us. Amen. Amen.
Very good. Well, we appreciate all the good songs that you've heard tonight. And remember, they do have CDs. You may order them. Okay, you can bring us up to date. Are y'all pastoring now, or what are you doing?
No, we're just evangelizing. We're mainly up to Brother George Sparks is where we call home anymore.
Mm-hmm.
but we're all over the place evangelizing and so on. And I'd love to do that, and appreciate it. The folks and other churches having confidence in us to ask us to come and speak for them and so on. So we're just trying to obey the Lord. And I want to thank the Lord tonight too, because when I come in here tonight, I've been having some eye problems, and I could not, and my eyes have burned and watered all day long. And I was really worried about how I was going to pull this off tonight. And because I knew those lights were bright.
They are.
And you know, I haven't been bothered a bit. But I've done a lot of praying, and I think everybody else did too.
Yes.
And I haven't had a bit of problem with those lights. In fact, I can look right at them tonight.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lord. That's great. That is wonderful. Okay, what would you like to share tonight?
Oh, I just praise the Lord for being here. I'm happy in the Lord. We are, like he said, evangelizing, and we just minister wherever we get opportunity and enjoying it.
Amen.
So how many years have you been singing together?
About 35 or something like that, I guess. Or more than
you'd
that.
You'd think we'd be better than that.
Well, I thought it was good.
As we get older along the way, we seem to make a lot of mistakes and so on, but you know, we just keep working for the Lord and and suck it up and go on, you know.
Well, yeah. There's not anything perfect in this world, but there's going to be a place that we, everything will be. And, you know, I was talking, Brother Fred was here the other night, and we was talking about how heaven's going to be. And, you know, we can't even imagine how wonderful it is. You know, we might have a good imagination, but it's not that good, because the Bible says that we can't. It's not entered into our mind or heart, the things that God's prepared for. So, you know, the best thing you could possibly think of is still not what He has, something better. And isn't that wonderful? He's so good to us. He saves us. He watches over us. He goes with us, and then prepares a place like that for us at the end.
Yeah. And praise the Lord. Yeah.
It's really a blessing, you know. I don't worry about things. I just go to sleep and put my trust in the Lord.
These people that have made the choice to walk with the Lord tonight, we want to encourage them to find them a local church someplace and get involved and work and grow and minister to others and tell people about the Lord's goodness and what He did for you.
Yes.
That's right.
Very good.
Amen.
Yes. And we do need to continue to grow in the Lord. It doesn't matter how long we've been saved. Right. We still are growing in Him if we're trying.
Yes.
Where do you all have something special planned for the holidays that you'll be singing?
Just family.
Just family.
Just family. We're going to be down at Pine Hill the first Saturday night in January. I kind of chose to stay a little closer home New Year's Eve because of the driving distance and so on and so forth. So,
Pine Hills in Irvin,
Pine Hill Baptist Church in Irvin, Kentucky.
Oh, okay.
Brother Williams, and his first name escapes me right now, but he's pastor there.
Well, speaking of Watch Night or New Year's Eve, we're going to have a short version of that. We're just going to be here for the regular time of an hour and a half, because Fred and I decided it's just too many hours till midnight. And also, so many churches are having their own Watch Night service, and so, you know, it's not as needed as it was when we first started it. And so we're going to be here for a little bit and have communion and so forth, but you know, just for those that can't get out.
All right,
a couple of minutes here. Anything else you want to
We want to thank the Lord for, I've got a brother, Estelle Atkins' wife has been really, really sick. She had cancer in the throat and so many difficulties. And I just want to thank the Lord and tell them howdy tonight if you're watching. But she is doing great now. She's gaining weight and she's getting her strength back. And we've just been so excited about that. He's a good preaching friend of mine. So.
All right, that's a good praise report.
Yes.
Well, anyone you want to wish Merry Christmas to?
Oh, yeah, all of my family. I got a sister in Mount Vernon, Geraldine Richards, and one in Campton. Well, actually, she's Wolf County, Freddie Hayes. And I'd like to say Merry Christmas to them.
Amen. Okay.
Some people seen me on here and thought she was on here singing, and she said, no, I don't sing.
George, you too. You have a Merry Christmas.
All right. Well, thank you all for coming tonight. We appreciate it, and thank the Lord for the salvation reports and all the prayer requests. So, and we're out of time. So from all of us here, this is the last night we'll have before Christmas, so we'll all wish you a Merry Christmas, and we'll be back Saturday night for regular service, but you'll have time to get all those presents and open them and enjoy them, and we'll be back in a few nights. So from all of us here, good night, and God bless you.
Yes.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O.